chose today chemical engineering because I think this is a type of engineering where I can utilize my skills, and I think this is the type of engineering that best suits me.
I wanted to be a chemical engineer because I love the subject chemistry, and that's all.
I chose chemical engineering as my course because since high school, I've excelled not just in chemistry but also in mathematics. I also like solving word problems that involve chemistry.
So I didn't really want to become a chemical engineer, but when I was preparing for application for college, I had to make a choice. So I had to do a process of elimination. So I didn't want really to become a doctor or a lawyer. So at the end, I chose engineering. And I chose chemistry because my professor in chemistry at that time, I really enjoyed the subject and really wanted to learn more about it.
I've chosen the engineering program, specifically chemical engineering, because my love in mathematics, science, and especially chemistry.
I chose chemical engineering as my course because chemical engineers solve the most impactful of our problems in the world. And I thought solving chemistry and calculus problems would be fun.
Siyempre, kunan pa tayo ng isang intervene. Pito kasi yung kailangan, pero anim pa lang yung nakakuha natin.
Ganun ba?
Ayun lang si JV.
Sige.
Uy, di ba kabla ka namin sa ano sa Anakem? Oh. Pwede ko ba namin may interview para doon sa project namin? May tatanong lang kami about sa chemical engineering.
Sige, ayos lang.
Sige.
So yung question is, bakit ka ng chemical engineering?
Chemical engineering.
Siguro kasi ano, mataas yung magiging sila. Tapos...
Ah, sorry bro. Oo,
Siguro pwede mo.
Sige. Okay, salamat!
Yeah, thank you!
I know why you're here. Let me tell you about the story on how chemical engineering started. It was way back around the time of the American Revolutionary War.
France especially was affected by these blockades because America is where it got its supply of sodium carbonate, also known as sodash. Since France couldn't get sodium carbonate through normal trade routes, in 1775, the French Royal Academy offered up a prize to anyone who could produce sodium carbonate from sodium chloride known as common salt. Around 1789, a French chemist and physician named Nicolas Leblanc finally figured out how to produce sodium carbonate from sodium chloride. His methods became the forerunner of modern chemical manufacturing and paved the way for future chemical engineers to come. In the late 19th century, British chemist George Davis worked as an inspector for Alkali Act. Around 1887, Davis gave a series of lectures at the Manchester School of Technology. In the US, his works helped to stimulate new ways of thinking about chemical processes and sparked the creation of chemical engineering degrees at universities around the country. In 1915, Arthur D. Little first introduced unit operations. Right now, chemical engineers are expanding its scope to newer and emerging fields of biotechnology, pharmaceuticals, food, and renewable energy.
In the field of personal care products, chemical engineers are responsible for designing and applying various methods in order for the ingredients to combine in order to produce a cosmetic product or personal care products. One example would be emulsion. This process forces oil and water to stabilize molecules with the use of emulsifiers.
Chemical engineers in the field of food and beverages does a lot of work on the production of the product. There are many principles involved in this field, like fluid mechanics are mostly used in the beverage industry. In the food industry part, chemical engineers are responsible for the enhancement of fruit and vegetable production, food packaging, protection of perishable foods, innovation in food, and safe food handling practices.
On the other hand,
Chemical engineers work in the field of energy and environment by making up solutions to food, fuel, and energy crisis. They create ways to produce these things efficiently and as environmentally safe as possible, causing little to no harm on our environment.
Chemical engineers play an important role in the medical field. They don't do surgeries and the likes to any patients, but they conduct researches and experiments to find new medical devices and procedures. It involves finding new medicine and medical solutions to different diseases that require more effectiveness.
Knowing that chemical engineers are equipped to design and operate industrial parts, they are also involved in creating cleaning materials such as soaps and detergents.
Chemical engineers can also work in the field of chemical industry. It involves the production of different chemicals like those found in a household, like bleach, detergent, table salt, and other things like fertilizers and alcohols. And table salt and other things. Chemical engineers use what they learn in school, like chemistry, physics, and mathematics, to solve problems in the production and consumption of food, fuel, drugs, and many other products. Chemical engineers work full-time either in offices or in industrial plants or both. They commonly work in big industrial factories such as refineries where they manage production lines.
According to a survey conducted by the American Institute of Chemical Engineers in 2015, annual salary of chemical engineers, those without advisory responsibility, ranges between $60,000 to $170,000.
As a chemical engineer, one should possess traits that a chemical engineer must have. First, chemical engineer must be critical.
The second is that chemical engineers should be genuine. And lastly, chemical engineers should be good at both worlds. They should be able to use their incredible knowledge in math, specifically in calculus, to properly do analysis, and at the same time, should be able to have good people skills to create a good working environment.
Chemical engineering is a vast area, thus making chemical engineers versatile, for they can do a lot of things. They manage production processes from planning, cost, design, until it's up and running.
In lieu of these, chemical engineers also conduct tests periodically and troubleshoot problems that arise during manufacturing. Lastly, chemical engineers continuously conduct research and development to improve present manufacturing processes.
Oh, so chemical engineers does a lot of work.
Chemical engineer is indeed extensive that utilizes one's ability and skills in different fields of chemical engineering. The process of becoming one is not that easy. As a first-year student taking this program, I find it very challenging. It is not something that you can just choose because of its appealing salary. It must be chosen because it is something that you want to do and one that can help you grow as a person. Chemical engineering requires an immense effort and patience because it deals with many different processes that involve the creation of new products and procedures, such as the transformation of raw materials into a usable product, improvement of less effective processes, the innovation of new efficient ideas, and many more. So now, I am more confident why I have chosen this program, completely knowledgeable of the path that I am taking and ready to face the future as a chemical engineer.